Welcome to
People vs. Wild!
Meet our contestants, Snooki, Bill Nye, and Miley Cyrus. We are in Iceland with...
Whoa!
That must be the Eurasian and North American plate moving away from each other, which produces earthquakes because the energy of the rocks are released and will give the ability to do work or produce heat.
Wow, that's real nice, Bill.
But we have to get off this island before we die!
I mean, the nearest airport is over that mountain!
We have to walk?
I don't think that's a mountain.
Let's go! So thirsty!
Oh, Snooki!
Hurry, Snooki, before the current of the river carries you away because you're standing on the top of a young river. That's high kinetic energy because the steep sides make the water run really fast. It will not stop until an unbalanced force stated in Newton's first law.
Yay, Snooki,
you saved! Okay, let's take a breather in this river.
We're gonna examine this situation.
Okay, why don't you start, Snooki?
Hey, there's a piece of rock from the weathered rock. My 5-inch heel must have stepped on the rock and must have been in the process of being abrasion. So my weight must have crushed it, such as the Newton's law, where the rock wanted to stay there, but the heel was the unbalanced force.
Wow, look at what Snooki just stepped on. It was frost wedging, meaning it is a form of mechanical weathering by the freezing of the water that has entered the pore of a crack of the rock. It is formed by the temperature of the rock freezes.
Wow, the mountain looks like it's never going to end. Probably because we are decelerating, because we are increasing our potential energy and decreasing our kinetic energy on this mountain.
Why are you guys so educational about Iceland? And why did Snooki get so smart? We must have inhaled a lot of this ash.
Well, we have strips. Oh. But this is no mountain. This is a volcano. It's going to explode! Wow, this is some hot lava. This must be a stratovolcano because the lava looks thick, making the viscosity level hot.
Whatever volcano it is, it makes really good marshmallows.
Look, the mountain is a volcano is a stratovolcano because the lava is slow moving.
Oh, I guess you're right. I wonder what the name of the volcano in the river we crossed was.
The river is the Sog River, and this volcano is called the Yakayakayoku Volcano. And this is a composite volcano because look how slow-moving the lava is.
How did you get so smart?
Well, I got this brochure at the highway we crossed.
Oh, that's really cool. Look at the pictures of these volcanoes.
Whoa!
Oh, that must be another earthquake. Did you know that earthquakes produce 3 sort types of waves, P waves, S waves, and L waves?
Oh yeah, I heard that. I heard the P waves are the fastest of the 3 because they're compressional and longitudinal.
And did you also know that the S waves are slower because they're transverse and move side to side?
And did you also know that the L waves are the most slowest of the 3 waves because they are surface waves?
Facts for life!
But we better get out of here fast. The more earthquake shakes, the more powerful it becomes. And it feels like there will be another. I know this because the energy of motion. The faster an object moves, the more kinetic energy it has.
I heard from recent volcano eruptions in Iceland that earthquakes are a good sign for major eruptions. We should get out of here, especially that we are right next to the volcano.
So we must be close to the fault line because that's where most eruptions occur.
Sometimes that's not true. We could just be the aftermath, but since we are at a volcano, we must be at a converging plate boundary too, because Those are the two forces of place coming together by compression.
Yes, but we have to get out of here. If we don't, the volcano will explode a lot of magma that has been trapped in from the last volcanic eruption because the viscosity of a volcano depends on a high silica.
Okay. Let's go. Just chill your overalls, guys. I'll call my helicopter to come get us.
You had a helicopter?
Yeah, I want it to be a surprise.
So are we going to the airport?
No, we're going to our potato farm.
No, of course we're going to the airport.
Guys, look at the eroded rock from the mountains. It's so beautiful. Like wedge pickles.
Yep, it's really cool. That is from the weathered of a wind and ice and forces of nature called mechanical weathering.
Or it could be from chemical weathering, from acid rain that reacts with the rock and make it into another composition.
Or it could be from chemical weathering also, but from hydrolysis, when water reacts with other substances to form a chemical reaction.
Or it could be from oxidation, where oxygen combines with other substances.
Or it could be also CO2, where it is found in the air and it reacts with water to form carbonic acid.
Look, it is the river that we saw where I fell and became magically smart.
Wow, look at all those bends, or meanders. Did you know the outside of the meander has the most kinetic energy and has which causes most weathering?
Yeah, I heard that from somewhere, that the inside of the meander is called the point bar. It's the point with the slowest kinetic energy.
That must be an old river, because I know it's a gentle slopes the way it creates meanders and large floodplains. It must not have as much kinetic energy as it used to.
Yeah, because younger rivers have steep slopes and high kinetic energy, creating fast waves and V-shaped plains with high slopes.
Hey, I wonder where all the pebbles and sand went to.
Well, it goes to the delta, where the sediments deposit, and that's called deposition. It's also when water leaves the channel, having less kinetic energy when a stream enters the lake or ocean, creating a delta.
Hey, is that an oxbow lake? It says that there is a lot of them that form in this river and this for sure.
An oxbow lake is when the meander is blocked off by the forces of the water and kinetic energy.
We're at the airport! Let's go to Jersey Shore! Woo!
Flights to America have been canceled.
Aww.
Oh, girl, please excuse me if I must be giving all. I'm trying to keep my hands off, but you're begging me for more. Round, 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 baby, low, low, low. It's the time, time pass, cause we're never getting old. Miami boy, you know how we play. I ain't playing with you, but I wanna play with you. Give me, got me good. Now watch me. Woo! It's a different species. Me and DC, let's party on the White House lawn. Tiger Woods and Jesse James equals Pitbull all night long. Wake up Barack and Michelle, let them know that it's on.